The font properties can be used to change aspects of the font itself. Font family sets the face of the font, and font size sets the size. Font style makes the font slanted. Font variant displays it using small caps, and font weight sets the thickness of the font. Then there is a shorthand property called font for setting all of the font properties in one declaration. To set the font face, we use the font family property. It can be a specific font name, such as Times, or a generic family name, such as Sans Serif. It can also contain a prioritized list of font names, so that if the browser does not support the first font, it will use the next one, and so on. Note that if the font includes spaces, it must be surrounded by double quotes. The font size can be specified using any unit of measure, or as a percentage of the parent font size. It also has a couple of predefined values. Larger and smaller are relative to the parent font size, and the others are absolute sizes. The default size is medium. Next, we have font style to make the text slanted. Italic is a cursive companion font to the normal face, and oblique is a slanted form of the normal face. However, they tend to be rendered the same. Then there is font variant to display the font using small caps instead of lowercase letters. We can make the text bold using the font weight property. Even though there are several weight values, most fonts only have one type of bold. Bolder and lighter sets the thickness relative to the parent element, and the numeric values are absolute weights. Bold is equal to 700, and normal is the same as 400. We can replace all of these properties using the font property. They must be set in the right order, which is font style, followed by font variant, weight, size slash line height, and font family. As long as we keep this order, we can leave out any one of them.